So we've talked about how we can use the get with forms, and now we're going to talk about how we send post data to the form. And it works pretty much the same way. We make a form out here, and then we tell it to send the data via post rather than via get. It's kind of like send it in a different envelope. And so we send it via post, and the data that comes in via post ends up, like the $get, in a variable called $post. Now we'll talk in a bit kind of the technical differences, but from an HTML perspective, it's super trivial. All you have to do if you want to send the data via post rather than get is say method equals post on the form. It's going to do the exact same thing as it would with the get. Now one of the things that you'll notice right away is there is no x guess equals 12 question mark, and that's because the data is no longer being transmitted on the URL. And it comes in because we've asked it to come into in the post variable, so it shows up just the same as key value pair, and the key is based on the name variable, the name attribute on the input tag, and the get is empty, right? So the get's empty because we didn't use a get and we didn't put anything on there. You can actually have both get parameters and post data, but in this case, I didn't put anything on the URL, and the browser didn't put anything on the URL because I said, please transport this data using post, not get. Now, turns out that post is generally more common, and so you don't see too often the URL getting ugly with lots of stuff at the end, but there will be times when you do it. And so there are just two ways to send it. On the get, it sends it on the end of the URL, and it sends a normal get request, just like we've been looking at so far. What happens with the post is it actually makes the connection, the HTTP connection, and then adds the data at the, as on that connection, and that's why it doesn't show up as part of the URL. And it allows the post, because it's part of the connection, not part of the URL, you can send a lot more data in post, and that's why we tend to prefer it. So if you think about how the get works, you know, the browser sends a get, and it actually just adds the parameters to the end of the URL that it asks for. And there's some headers of information that it sends, but that's the get request. Whereas if you tell the browser to do a post, it sends the command post as part of the HTTP request, no parameters here, and then some header information, and then a blank line, and then key value pairs here. And there's a lot of complexity about how this actually works. They're URL encoded and MIME encoded and all these kinds of things, form encoded, right there, form URL encoded. For the simple one, in the case it's just a key and a simple value, it's key value, and then the ampersand would be here, and there's all kinds of encoding that happens. But the difference is that the reason you don't see it on the URL, you see it on the URL in get, and you don't see it on the URL in post, because it just sends it as part of this overall connection, and that closes the connection, and then the code of form3.php starts to run. And so it's just that's the mechanics of how it gets transferred to the server, right? The mechanics are it goes in, it is... Instead of being on the URL, it comes as sort of an extra bit on the end. It parses it and puts in the post request, and then our code starts up in the server and runs. So this is a pretty complex summary of the rules of when you would use get and when you would use post. The key thing is that if you're modifying data, you should never use a get. And it has to do with the fact that search engines will follow get URLs, but they won't follow post URLs. So if you're deleting something or inserting something or say adding a comment to a blog post or something, that should be a post request, never a get request. The only time that you would actually do a form of the get request is kind of like a search field or a lookup field, because they're supposed to be what are called idempotent, which means if you hit them twice, they're supposed to roughly contain the same material. So if you have a, part number equals 1234 and you hit that URL, it should give you part 1234's page, and if you hit it again, it should still give you part 1234's page. It might give you a slightly different like inventory level or something, but the idea of idempotent is you're not supposed to get different information when going to the same URL. The other thing is there is a limit about how much data you can send on GET. Each browser does it differently, and it changes over time, so there's not a number. It's bigger than you probably need ever for normal things. It just means if stuff gets above a certain size, like if you're like typing a paragraph, you almost always should send it as a post. You know, if you're typing a part number or something. And so given that you're probably typing a paragraph, you're probably sending that data in to modify something. So rule number one of if something's being created or modified, always use post. So up next, we're going to talk about a number of different form input types beyond just this text and the submit button.